Virginia Real Estate Salesperson Practice Exams and Study Guide, written by the Real Estate Training Team, narrated by Scott R. Pollak. Important disclaimers. The information contained within this book is strictly for informational purposes. The author and publisher do not make any guarantee as to the accuracy of this work. The author does not assume and hereby disclaims any liability to any party for any loss, damage, or disruption caused by errors or omissions, whether such errors or omissions result from accident, negligence, or any other cause. We are not responsible for your actions and cannot guarantee results or success. The author of this book is not affiliated with PSI, DPOR, or any of the Virginia State Real Estate Boards. The use of the information in this book or any products and services recommended should be based on your own due diligence, and you agree that our company is not liable for any success or failure in your business that is directly or indirectly related to the purchase and use of our information, products, or services. For additional real estate resources, training, videos, and much more, you can visit us online at www.therealestatetrainingteam.com. How to use this book. This book is intended to provide you with the knowledge necessary to pass the Virginia State portion of the real estate exam. Although you can skip directly to the practice exams, I would be sure to reference all of the material in this guide. This guide first covers how the test works and what you need to know about taking the exam. Then there is a study guide page that includes the material in note form so that you can quickly reference the information. After that, we have 5 practice exams with answers. Then, lastly, there is a real estate glossary of terms at the end to help you ace the exam. The questions on these practice tests come directly from the Virginia State Resources and a licensed Virginia real estate broker. There are 200 questions in this guide with 5 practice exams to give you a thorough understanding of the material. On the actual state Virginia real estate exam, you will only get 40 questions. While I can't guarantee you will pass the actual exam, I can say that if you spend even just an afternoon on this material with focused study, your chances will significantly increase. What you need to know about the test. 1. What are the requirements for taking the test? 60 hours of studying from an approved provider, fingerprinting and ID. You must be 18 and have a high school degree or equivalent. 2. How to register for an exam. Once your education provider submits your required hours, you can register for your exam on www.psiexams.com by calling them at 1-800-733-9267 or sending your application via mail to PSI. 3. How many questions does the Virginia exam consist of? 40 questions. 4. How much time do you have to finish the exam? 45 minutes. 5. What is a passing score for the exam? 75%. In other words, you have to get at least 30 out of 40 questions correct. 6. What if you fail the first time? You can retake the exam as soon as the next day. 7. Where are the exam locations? All over Virginia. For updated sites, look at PSI's website. 8. What do you need to bring on the day of the test? You need 2 forms of ID, and you have to arrive at least 30 minutes early, and there are storage bins for your things. 9. Additional info? The exam is done mostly via computer, and the test proctor will give you an introductory 15-minute tutorial on how to complete the exam. 10. When do you find out your score? If you use a computer, the score will be given to you immediately following the exam completion. If you choose to take the test with paper and pencil, your results will be mailed to you. Quick Study Guide Cheat Sheet. There are 6 different components to the test. and in this section we will go over all the information in note form. Part 1. Licensing. Qualifications for a salesperson include being at least 18 years old, having a high school diploma or equivalent, 60 hours of a qualifying real estate course, a reputation for honesty and fair dealing, no licenses from other areas that have been revoked, no convictions, no previous violations of fair housing laws. Qualifications for a broker. Experience as a real estate salesperson for at least 36 of the past 48 months, being at least 21 years old, having 180 hours of approved real estate courses, a reputation for honesty and fair dealing, no previous convictions or violations. Who is exempt from real estate licensing requirements? This includes auctioneers, trustees, attorneys, and owners. License by reciprocity. Reciprocal licenses. Virginia has licensee agreements with all states, meaning that if you have a license in another state, you can be licensed in Virginia with just a few requirements, including being in good standing. Brokers' supervisory requirements include a supervising broker at every branch office, providing adequate supervision and training to the licensees, conducting an audit of the brokerage at least every 2 years, maintaining records for 3 years and providing them upon request. Additional requirements for brokerages: must maintain a place of business in the Commonwealth of Virginia where real estate transactions can take place. Must display the name of the brokerage and make it clear that it is real estate, including using words such as real estate or realty. Virginia Real Estate Board. It has 9 members, including 7 licensed agents or brokers, 2 citizen members, and the terms of board members is 4 years. Changes. The VREB, Virginia Real Estate Board, must be notified of changes in the brokerage address or name within 30 days. If a licensee is transferring to or from another brokerage, the VREB must be notified within 10 days. VREB authority. They can suspend or revoke licenses, deny a license renewal, put licensees on probation for further educational requirements, issue cease and desist orders to brokers, impose a civil penalty up to $2,500 per infraction, refer the matter to the Commonwealth Attorney, and they are not allowed to impose a prison sentence. DPOR, Virginia Department of Professional and Occupational Regulation, role. They enforce license and regulatory issues, handle complaints against licensees, and investigate unlicensed activities. Improper dealings include when an agent does not disclose information to a client or customer, and they should have, not disclosing brokerage relationships, listing a property for sale on terms that the owner has not authorized. VREB requests. If VREB requests records or information, you have 10 days to provide it to them. Conflicts of interest. If you receive compensation from someone other than your broker, then that is not allowed. You must also provide full disclosure and receive written permission of both parties to a transaction if you are representing more than one party in a deal. Misrepresentations and omissions. This includes making false statements, untruthful advertising, or failing to disclose adverse facts. Improper brokerage. Acts include net listings, where a broker is allowed to keep the difference between the seller's listing price and the final sales price, paying a transaction-based fee to a non-licensed agent, accepting commissions from someone outside of the principal or supervising broker, commingling funds from an earnest money deposit. Virginia Real Estate Transaction Recovery Fund. New licensees must pay $20 into it. The fund must keep a minimum balance of $400,000. If the fund falls below the minimum balance, then each licensee will be assessed $20. The most amount a single claimant can recover from the fund is $20,000 for one transaction if the fund exceeds $2 million. Any excess money goes towards the Virginia Housing Partnership Fund. If a licensee is required to make a payment to the transaction...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.